Here is the outline of the dart throwing program. We need to complete the part here where x and y should be random numbers between minus 1 and 1. So we can't just call generator next double, because that gets a value between 0 and 1. And we want a value from minus 1 to 1. So here's the trick. Take the value from 0 to 1, multiply by 2, that gives you a value from 0 to 2, and then you subtract 1, which shifts it to the left by 1. Here is the final expression. And of course, the very same expression will work for y. Now we need to find out whether the point lies in the unit circle. You can compute the distance just like you've done in the telescope problem, but it's actually a little easier in this case. I can take the square of the distance and check whether that's less equal 1, because the square root of 1 is just 1. Don't worry about it if you just use the formula. This is not a math class, so any correct formula will do. Let's run the program. It wants the number of tries. We'll try a million, and we get a pretty respectable estimate for pi. Now, like I said, there are better ways of computing pi, but this method of using random numbers for measuring objects is really powerful when the object is irregular, when it's easy to find out whether a point lies in it, but when it's hard to compute the area with traditional means.